When we hear the word leadership here at Norwich, we think of many things. People with vision, drive, courage, and the ability to serve with honor. Great leaders come to mind here at Norwich. I'm surrounded by some of those names. Each day, walking around the campus, we can see these names. Some of their names are on buildings, plaques, centennial stairs. How did they get there? What makes them so special that they are recognized for the ages? I believe that such a person who chooses to come to Norwich possesses in their soul the will and the ability to lead, and under the right circumstances, with the right guidance, true leaders emerge. Men and women with the courage to go out and lead others to greatness. That's what separates Norwich women and men from the pack. Eight Norwich men have received the Medal of Honor, the nation's highest and most rarely awarded decoration. The first was Henry Clay Wood, class of 1856, who was awarded his for gallantry in the Battle of Wilson's Creek during the Civil War. The youngest was Willie Johnson, class of 1870, a 13-year-old drummer who stayed the course when many threw down their guns. And our most recent Senior Chief Special Warfare Operator, Edward Byers, a Navy SEAL, enrolled in Norwich's online program. His courage and commitment demonstrated during a hostage rescue in Afghanistan in support of Operation Enduring Freedom. Whether they were honored for their gallantry, bravery, or heroism, each of these men faced ethical challenges under exceptional circumstances, and each chose to do the right thing at the time of greatest need, regardless of the implications to themselves.
I am Lieutenant General Dave Quantock. I'm the Army Inspector General. I think what really led to this position, I was in charge of bringing Abu Ghraib back up. So I got a lot of notoriety from days I thought I was going to get relieved to days that we did pretty amazing to try and fix the issues that came out of the Abu Ghraib scandal. I've been lucky, extremely lucky, because over my career, I've been surrounded by heroes. From the time growing up in an Army family, to being around just unbelievable non-commissioned officers and brave soldiers and great civilians that when you're surrounded by great people, you can get pretty lucky and end up in this job. What I have found is if you have respect, and my father told me that a long time ago, respect is the coin of the realm. And if your folks respect you, it will follow you down the barrel of a cannon. So if I'm gonna, you know, require somebody to do a 12-mile road march, I'm gonna be out there and do the 12-mile road march. If I'm gonna expect my soldiers to be out there getting shot at, then I'm gonna be out there with them. One of the key aspects of being a leader is humility, appreciating what you have, and creating that positive climate. I learned it at Norwich, and I've tried to apply that throughout my entire career. So as a leader, you don't need to beat people down. It's about catching people doing the right thing.
Leading from the front and leading by example is very important. As a regimental commander, you're setting the standard and you're setting the tone for the entire Corps of Cadets. I think personally what I'm going to walk away with from Norwich is how to take care of your people. It's important for your subordinates to know that you care as a leader, and there's no better way to show that you care than actually getting out there and working with people and getting to know your people. So it's about having that balance to come forward and say something when something absolutely needs to be said, but also having the balance of always recognizing when they're doing something right. Norwich has been a real pivoting moment for me in my life because I've found what type of leader I am and I found what I'm capable of. And without Norwich, I wouldn't have been able to find those things.
Since 1819, Norwich has been instilling important values, such as leading by example and putting service before self. John Moynihan, a 2003 graduate from Norwich, who joined the Army and became an Army Ranger, has served his country with distinction and valor. John returned to his hometown in 2009 to join the Boston Police Department. He was among the first responders in the Boston Marathon bombing. Last year, Moynihan himself was a victim of violence, shot in the face at a point-blank range during a routine traffic stop. While still undergoing treatment, John's goal is to return to the police force and continue to serve his community with distinction.
So for me, this is my first federal job, and coming from private sector, you have to have the desire to serve the nation, to provide service to the community. My role is Chief Information Security Officer and Chief Privacy Officer for Office of Comptroller of Currency under US Treasury. People see me as a leader that they can trust, and because I lead by example in everything that I do, so the team that works with me and is with me, we believe in teamwork. And what values I follow in a day-to-day life, what they see me do, obviously it permeates in the organization.
Our business is an aerospace engineering business. We're a services company. We support a number of different customers, primarily the Air Force, the Navy, the Missile Defense Agency. We support companies like Lockheed, Boeing, etc. One thing that I think that we've done at MTSI that I can directly relate back to my experience at Norwich. My senior year, I was a company commander in the Corps of Cadets. We put together some programs to mentor and tutor some of our underclassmen. We knew what they were going through. You know, we took great pride in watching those underclassmen succeed. And so I relate that as it relates to MTSI because we have a number of core values in the company. And the number one core value is a little bit different than you might see in other companies. And our number one core value is employees come first. And so I think about how we took care of those underclassmen and allowed them to be successful as the same tenet that we have at MTSI.
Alden Partridge founded this institution to educate and train citizen soldiers to defend our country in times of war and build our nation in times of peace. General Grenville Dodge is among Norwich's best-known citizen soldiers. He graduated in 1851 with a degree in civil engineering and spent the next decade as a civilian surveying railroads in the Midwest. He then joined the Union Army at the start of the Civil War. After a noteworthy military career, he became, once again, a successful businessman, a U.S. congressman, and then chief engineer of the Union Pacific Railroad. Dodge is just one example of the many Norwich leaders who have committed their lives in the service of their nation over the past two centuries.
My name is Mike Teague, and I'm the Secretary of both Energy and Environment for the state of Oklahoma.
If you think of what Grenville Dodge accomplished, everybody thinks of the railroad. And to be able to bring all those pieces together, I mean, those are the lessons that I draw from to do what we do now. If you're going to talk about increasing renewable energy in the state of Oklahoma, well, that's bringing utilities together, that's developers together, that's landowners together, that's environmental groups together, that's the ag community. All of those people need to be part of that conversation so you get the best solution. If you can bring both of those sides into a conversation, then you really can lead towards making lasting changes.
Everything you do is about putting together the right team of the right people. And I think that goes back to my roots at Norwich.
I went to Norwich because I wanted to be in the Army. I loved my Army career, but there are so many aspects of how the leadership from a military school and a military career apply to the rest of the world, and so much that needs to be done. So I love that term, citizen soldier. I continue to try to improve myself as a leader 30 years after I graduated. But that first step, that first four-year block at Norwich of learning how to truly lead your peers and take responsibility for your own actions as well as those of a unit, that absolutely was the starting point for me.
One of the projects that I'm really excited about is the new micro house project that we're working on. Alden Partridge said, we need to act as well as conceive. And for architecture students, building and making is our way of action.
We are trying things that other people aren't trying. And we're looking at the micro houses right now as a way of figuring out how to get making a house even more affordable.
I'm extremely proud to be a part of this. I think that not only is it building my resume, but it's giving, you know, Norwich a good product. It's giving me a good product to say, you know, I had a hand in on that. And then someone else is going to love it and live in it. So, I mean, you want to sort of have a pride in what you do for someone else.
We talk about the citizen soldier in the School of Architecture. We also talk about the citizen architect. So how can we as architects make differences in our community? How can we be part of a larger solution? Those are things that our students are thinking about.
Today's students who are walking in your footsteps will go on to live a life such as yours. We need your leadership now. You are today's leaders, and we need your help in ensuring that this university remains viable into our third century of service to this nation. We need you to step up to help us provide our young people with the unlimited opportunities that you learned about while you were a student here at Norwich.
We've made an award-winning building on a field in Vermont. Imagine what we can do when we actually have space to truly make and build something, designated space for making.
Others did it for me and gave me this opportunity that allowed me to become who I became, and Norwich played a significant role in who I became. I feel a strong draw to be able to give back to others because others did it for me, and so now it's my turn to do it for others.
Norwich Forever means exactly what it says.
And no matter what you do,
set the standard and lead people into the future, not from behind, but out in front. Show them what you know about leadership.